In this video, I will show you a few hacks how to get much more performance out of any braided line. Before going any further, I will take a minute to explain what advantages braided lines has over monofilament or fluorocarbon lines. In my opinion, there are two main advantages. First of all, braided lines are much stronger than monofilament or fluorocarbon lines, about 5 times stronger to the same diameter. Then, braided lines has no stretch, and monofilaments and fluorocarbons most of the time have up to 20% stretch in them, so that's not good when it comes to bite indication. And now about the disadvantages braided lines may have. In my opinion, there are two. First of all, braided line most of the time will be too soft. Therefore, those Japanese manufacturers like EGK, Gosen and others working very hard to get the stiffness just right so it would be soft enough to easy casting, but it wouldn't be too soft, so it would create like wind knots and wraparounds around the rod tip. And I believe that's why those Japanese braids are so expensive. For example, G-braid, the older version, was great line, but it was too soft. It was very good for casting, but not so good for fishing in the wind. Then it used to create wind knots and wrap around the tip, so not ideal really. Then the second issue you may have with the braided line is the sound or loudness of the line. Obviously, braided line, it's braid, the surface is not even. So that friction between the line and between the rod's guides and reel's rotor and the spool when you are casting will create some sound, and some lines will be louder than others. For example, this cheap one, Piske von Lunker, is great line, but when it's new, it's actually a little bit too loud. Okay, I talked about a couple of issues, but I found a perfect way how to overcome those issues and get much more performance even out of great and expensive lines as well. Okay, and how to overcome those issues you might have with braided lines. First of the things I will talk about, that's a Varivas PE spray. I won't be able to tell what is it, the contents or anything, because everything is in Japanese basically. But Varivas is a Japanese brand which makes mostly stuff for lure fishing. Basically, that's some kind of a spray which you just spray onto the braided line, and it dries fast in about a minute. And then I used this stuff for a while, and I will try to express what are like my feelings or what I noticed when it comes to the differences when using this stuff and when you are not using. Basically, the line becomes just a little bit stiffer and slicker, so it helps with the casting, and also it helps with reducing those tangles around the rod tip. Also, what I noticed that quite often after you kind of have to break pull to break into the snag, or when you are landing a couple fish and the braided line, those couple meters like from the lure to the rod tip, gets kind of weaker. But when you are using this stuff, it seems that the line just does not care at all. It just behaves like a new line, more or less. And it lasts, this stuff, I would say, for 1 or 2 sessions, not longer. So you have to apply, ideally, on the spool just before every session, I would say. Then you will have optimum performance. I have to say that this stuff is quite expensive. That's a 50 ml bottle, and it did cost about 15 Great Britain pounds. So it will be about $20 or 15 euros as well. So quite expensive. Again, it will last depending on the usage, obviously, but still, it's expensive stuff. And the worst thing is that you can't obtain it like easily. At this point, I'm not able to get that kind of stuff, or this exact stuff in the UK. I'm not able to get it. And now about the big boy, which I discovered actually is working even better than this one. So that's a WD-40 Specialist Anti-Friction Dry PTFE Lubricant. So it says PTFE. What is that? Basically, I will try to say its chemical title if I will be able to. So that will be polytetrafluoroethylene. Basically, that's a stuff which is used for non-stick pans, and this stuff gives also, as you can hear, it has a ball bearing inside. So this stuff works very, very similarly to this expensive one, but it costs like, I think, about £6 in the UK, and you are getting 400 milliliters, so 8 times more. And as it's cheaper, like almost 3 times cheaper, so about 12 times cheaper it will be than to use this one. And this one also is a little bit better when it comes to longevity. So when you use this one, you can get and you will see the difference in about 2 or 3 sessions and long sessions as well. And this stuff is awesome. I have to say I like it. Basically, it also helps with the casting, what I noticed. I would say it's very difficult to put into the numbers, but I would say maybe 5 to 10 extra meters it will give you on the cast, because that PTFE, that's basically the slickest or least friction having material known to the man. So it basically reduces the friction in between the line wraps and in between the line and the spool as well. And it really, really works. And it dries not as fast as this stuff. Probably takes a couple minutes or maybe 3 minutes to dry. But once it's dry, it really, really improves the performance of the reel. And you apply it very, very simply. Just spray on the... I will try not to get it onto the lens. Just spray. And as it's cheap, you can like really, really infuse a braid with this stuff. I found that the more you get that stuff onto the line, the better it works. And I'm not saying that kind of as I not used that. I use that for a couple months now, and it's really, really helping with the braided line's performance. So yeah, get one of these, use it around the house and also on your braided lines. I hope this video will be helpful for you guys. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.